I'm here representing a foreign newspaper. Juan Manuel, you start from the perspective of someone that reports locally in New York, but I come from Spain to report for initially Spanish readers. As you may know, El País is Spain's largest newspaper. We have between 300,000 and 400,000 circulation in Spain. We also have editions in Latin America and Europe. We have a joint edition with the New York Times and with the International Herald Tribune. We also have a website that gets 18 million users a month. 30% of that circulation comes from international places, mostly Latin America and also the United States. And I'm saying that I come here as a foreigner because, you know, like traveling throughout the country, covering politics, I always have to report for Spain, coming from a country that where Spanish is the main language and from the long relationship that we've had with the continent, right? So for me, I tend to see things as comparing them to Europe and the media here, the Spanish-speaking media here, and the Spanish-speaking media in Europe or other Latin American countries is very different, and I'll go into that. But covering politics, I've had the chance to interview, I would say, most of the most visible leaders for the Hispanic community here. I mean in the political sense, because I live and work in Washington, D.C., so I talked to Liliana Ross Letinen, who is now the president of the Committee of International Affairs at the House of Representatives. I've interviewed several times Marco Rubio, who is the new star senator, maybe for future vice presidential candidate, who knows, maybe presidential candidate, first Latino that would be there in the Republican Party. Also Bob Menendez from New Jersey. Talking to these people working at Washington, D.C., which has also a big Hispanic population, having been to Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, Nevada, I see there's a lack of unity and purpose in the political level in the Hispanic community in this country. Everybody I talk to in my travels covering political and social issues, any Hispanic here would say, well, immigration reform is, along with the economy, I guess, and unemployment, but immigration reform is something that we want to have. People remember Ronald Reagan, not because he was Republican, not because Hispanic people, most of them, because he did immigration reform, even though he was Republican, you know, that's what people say. And now we want the same, you know, there are, I don't know how many, like 15 million people that need to be, that are in this country without the required documentation. So if this is such an important issue for the community, why not pushing for it as a group, you know, as a group of politicians, as a coalition, you know, across borders, in Congress? I think there's a lack of media pressure there too. It may be the nature of this country, of immigration in this country, it may be the federal composition of the country, it may be other things. If we see a map, we may see that huge congregations, huge groups of Hispanics in the typical states that we all know. There's Florida with 3 million Hispanics there, then there is Texas, there is New Mexico, there is Arizona, Nevada, California, South California. We all know that. But if you read deep into the latest data that the census revealed recently, you'll see that actually Hispanic population is not growing there. It's growing in Illinois, it's growing in New York, it's growing in the Washington, D.C. area, it's growing in Baltimore, Maryland, Virginia, it's growing in Tennessee. So you see that it's not only a southern, it's not a border thing, it's a national resurgence, it's a national growth of the Hispanic population. And I think this has to come too with the pressing, with the push forward of a political agenda. For that, you need the media. I brought a quote, this maybe a little pedantic, but it's one of my favorite quotes regarding this by Marshall McLuhan, who is a philosopher and he knows a lot about the media. And he said something that is, societies have always been shaped more by the nature of the media by which men communicate than by the content of the communication, which is media shapes society. I come from a country that it's not federal, but it has some type of like individual, you know, communal, regional decentralizations. But we have a national media covering the whole country. I don't see that here. I come from a smaller country, 45 million people, which is almost the size of the Hispanic population here. But my point there is I don't see a Spanish-speaking or a Hispanic New York Times or Wall Street Journal or even magazines, you know, like the New Yorker. I don't see quality national reporting for all the country. And I just don't mean Hispanic newspapers that cover Hispanic issues. I mean newspapers in Spanish that cover all issues, you know, politics, national politics, regional politics, culture. For that, of course, you need money and investment. You also may need a need for that within the readers, you know, people asking that. But I see a lot of local stations, I see a lot of local newspapers, but not something that goes national. I mean, I have some data here about the circulation of the biggest newspapers in this country. The number one is the Wall Street Journal, the conservative newspaper from New York. It's 2.1 million readers a day, which is a lot. USA Today is the second one, which is 1.8 million readers. The New York Times is almost 1 million. There are two Hispanic publications there. One of them is La Opinión in LA, which according to the Audit Bureau of Circulations has 100,000 readers. And then we have OI that is represented here too. So those may be the biggest newspapers, also anchored in LA and Chicago too, sorry. So my point there is that the Hispanic community would benefit more to push those issues if they had national media with a strong coverage of all issues. What are the reasons for the lack of that in the current market? Thinking about it, I come up with two ideas that I may just throw there. But one of them is like the let's say, dividing nature of the media here. You have the New York Times is from New York. The LA Times is from LA. You know, maybe the USA Today is the only national newspaper, but you know, like it lacks a deep coverage of most issues, you know. Wall Street Journal, New York too, you know. So this market favors local newspapers that may go national depending on their quality and the investment of money or not. The second one, and yeah, I know 2 minutes. The second one, and I'll finish with this, is, you know, I found a study from the Pew Research Center who does very accurate reports on like the state of the Hispanic community here that said that 23% of first generation Latinos speaks English. If you go to second generation, that jumps to 88%. If you go to third generation, that jumps to 94%. They were talking about that transition to English dominance within the Hispanic community. Then another data that you may find interesting, 7% of foreign-born Hispanics speaks English as a first language at home, 7%. 50% of their children, it is like second generation, 50% speak English as a first language. I'll finish with a story that happened to me in Texas covering a polygamous compound there, which is like another story. But I went to a house of a Hispanic family there, and I tried to talk to a guy who, to me, looked Hispanic, you know? So I walked towards him, he was like maybe 17. I was like, I spoke Spanish, you know? I just arrived here and my English was not, it's not good now, but it was not as good as it is now. And I tried to get some information from him and I spoke Spanish, like, ¿Cómo estás? ¿Me puedes ayudar? He didn't know what I was talking about. It's like, well, aren't you like, yeah, I came here when I was like two, you know? But his parents, in order to integrate him, he told me, they shielded him. So no Spanish home, and no Spanish out of the home. So he didn't speak Spanish. And that is very common. So it's like, what newspapers do you read? Well, I read the Times, I read the USA Today. So maybe these new generations don't find the need of Spanish-speaking newspapers because they don't have it, because they can read them in English. So that may be our problem as a community here too. And that's